Okay, so what is up, guys? It is Aiden back at it again for another video. And guys, today this is my first ever music type video on this channel, so let me know what you guys think. But today's artist that we're going to be talking about is Earl Sweatshirt. And you guys are probably wondering, why am I talking about Earl Sweatshirt? Because I feel like he has a really big impact on the rap scene, the Odd Future scene, the boom bap trap era, you know, the MF Doom minis, the mini MF Dooms. I'm talking like Joey Badass, Capital Steez, and you know, people like that. And I feel like he really made the wave with his music. So yeah, with dropping his first mixtape when he was only 16 years old, from making his first ever mixtape Kitchen Cutlery by the name Sly Tendencies, from being found by Tyler the Creator, from being in Odd Future with members such as Frank Ocean, Taco Bennett, Jasper, and Tyler the Creator himself. But today, we're not going to be talking about that stuff. We're going to be talking about his debut album, Doris.
Yeah, she get it cause he mean it. He's a free smoking niggas need it. Mask off, mask on, we trick or treating. Back off, standoffish and anemic.
Okay, so 6 months after Earl Sweatshirt linked up with Odd Future, he dropped his debut mixtape, Earl. Now, about 2 months later, after he dropped this mixtape, his mom sent him to an island in Samoa because she felt that he was going through a rough patch in his life, like skipping school, doing drugs, you know, just doing a whole bunch of bad things. So his mom sent him away to Samoa, but later would he know that this trip would change his life forever.
Addicts arise when I arrive in this crack crack bag, back slap in disguise. Fat sack of knives in the passenger side. Bitch, reach for the door, get your access denied.
But while he was in Samoa, he was going through a rehabilitation. I don't know how to say it, but he met other boys like him who were, you know, emo skaters that did drugs, skipped school, and this and that. But when he had this program, he changed a lot, and he really looked back on his past and how the lyrics that he used were not okay, and he met victims of things that he was talking about, and he knew that he had to change in a way his lyrics, his personality, everything. But back home, Odd Future was getting a lot of popularity, like blowing up like crazy. And it's crazy because he couldn't enjoy his success of his mixtape Earl. So that was really, it was good when he went back home, because that's when the success came in. As soon as Earl returned from Samoa, he dropped his debut studio album Doris on August 20th, 2013. Now this album blew him up in popularity. Some features such as Mac Miller, Tyler, Frank Ocean, RZA, and Vince Staples. Now you can really tell how Earl Sweatshirt changed with the lyrics and how he, you know, previewed himself on this album. It's dark, it's moody, it touches on some touchy subjects, but overall I give it a 6.10 because it is a good album, but there is some skips. Pitchfork gave it an 8.5, I'm pretty sure. I'll put it up on the screen. It was even on the Billboard charts. So that's how you know it was doing good and Earl changed for the better. If you guys did enjoy this video, please make sure to like and subscribe. And I'll see you guys on the next one. Let me know if you guys like videos like this. And yeah, peace.
Addicts arise when I arrive in this crack crack bag, back slap in disguise. Fat sack of knives in the passenger side. Bitch, reach for the door, get your access denied.